Let me tell you something. I was listening to this song. It's a girl, her name is Sizzo. In the song, she say, oh, your man is my man. I'm keep him in the weekend. Let me tell you something. There is no foolishness like that here, okay? My man is my man. Epi, that's it. He's not your man, he's my man, and I want you to understand that. Because if you make the malheur, if you make the mistake, if you take my man for the weekend, I'm going to take all your weekend and all the other days away from you. You understand that? I'm taking one trip to Haiti for you, and I'm going to remove all the weekend from you. No more weekend, no more weekdays, everything finished. You understand that? So you can say bye-bye to the weekend, bye-bye Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, bye-bye Friday. Everything is finished for you. You understand that? I'm Haitian. I don't play that bullshit.
Fuck you, mister. Oh, fuck you in here!
With another exciting video. Now, before I even start this video, I want you guys to hit that like button, because you know I drop the most flagrant videos on YouTube about this subject. None other than the Intranquil Spirit. Well, I'm going to correct that title, because this is what we know, according to common knowledge. The Intranquil Spirit. What Intranquil Spirit are you talking about? Is the question. There's many, so there can't be the Intranquil Spirit. An Intranquil Spirit is classified as any spirit who died in a horrific manner. It can be through illness, through violence, through suicide, so and so. Now, when we're talking about Intranquil Spirits, these are utilized by people to bring their lovers back, as well as to harm individuals. Well, in this video, I'm going to cover Intranquil Spirit's uses for bringing lovers back, as well as seeking revenge. When we're talking about Intranquil Spirits, from a Haitian perspective, we look at Marinette Piesesh as our Intranquil Spirit. We don't use the language of espiritu tranquilo or speaking of tranquille. We don't use that terminology. We look at it as a loi. But now, when we're talking about the image which is associated with Marinette Piesesh, it is Anima Sola. And for those people out there that are accustomed working with Anima Sola, maybe you'll find something in this story, in what I'm going to say. When you're looking at Anima Sola, you find a lady with chains broken, burning in a purgatory. But there is a symbolic message behind that photo. It gives us an illustration that we are living in the purgatory. We, as human beings, have the ability to leave this purgatory state. We can also look at it in its traditional meaning of one leaving the grips of hell or the purgatory. But now, the fire in this purgatory is symbolically representing the pains and woe of life. From a Haitian perspective, in the experiential path of experience, from knowledge, marinette, pièce sèche, i.e. anima sola, is not used amongst many, unless it's in dire situations. Because we utilize the terminology kopobe to talk about crippling. She has the ability to cripple human beings. Not only that, she can bring death to human beings as well as life-threatening illnesses. This is why it is something that, this is a spirit that we put to the side and we don't utilize. Now, an experienced Boko knows how to utilize this energy. A lot of people, they want this energy, but when they see the circumstances that begin to happen, they begin to have a change of heart. I'm going to give two examples. I remember this lady reached out and sought out a work dealing with the tranquil spirit. Now, I must say this, that this is, I'm going to say this in a manner not to, let's say, read between the lines. That I say. So this lady got this tranquil spirit job done. I'm going to give two examples. Actually, yes, I'm going to give two examples. This individual, this lady had lovers in her life, and this is the thing I say to people when they seek out to work with marinette pièce sèche. This energy scatters. It doesn't hit one target, it hits everyone. Every lover that's in your life, they feel the effects of the work. This lady, she had this guy that she was dealing with. And what happened was, this guy, let's just say he treated her bad and he left her. Child's father, you know, that's her child's father. She didn't deal with him for a long time. And what happened was she was working on a recent lover. The spirit that she was dealing with was marinette pièce sèche. The baby father got caught in the path of marinette pièce sèche. He was shot multiple times and now he's paralyzed. And this individual sent me a photo to show me of the guy's rear end, how he has bed lacerations, or the terminology they use, bed scars from sitting on material so long. So you can see his buttocks is flushing red. Now, what happened to the individual that she was working on? And I believe this transpired in about a 4 months time period. She tells me this individual gets into a vicious car accident. Said he could have lost his life, everything broke up, and things of that nature. To each his own. She was satisfied with the results. See, one thing a person has to understand is that you have to decide whether or not this is for you or whether it's not for you. Because the next person can say, you know what, I don't want to deal with this anymore, I'm done, I don't want no more part of this.
Fuck you, mister.
You have to find out what fits you. The next story goes, a young lady, she sought out to work with marinette pièce sèche. She says, I want to go to extreme manner. As soon as she saw the person's mother catch cancer, the person's soon to be child's mother lose the baby, and start seeing multitude of events transpiring, that which would be classified as horrific, the person freaked out and said they don't want no more part of it. So when you're talking about doing, utilizing this force to bring back a lover, you got to be sure in your heart, this is what you want. Because when you get it, you have to accept everything that comes with it. Now, I want to move on to talking about utilizing entrampled spirits to seek revenge. The most common uses of entrampled spirits is basically graveyard spirits. People who died in horrific ways, whether they died in a car crash, whether they died in prison or whatever, they utilize these forces, or whether they died of cancer or died of AIDS, they utilize this energy to bring about the same circumstance which transpired and caused the spirit's death. A guy was hung. I remember there's this person that I know. They was utilizing an entrancled spirit for revenge. And I guess they put the spirit's and stuff in a location that it shouldn't have been. And this person started complaining about their neck hurting, there was so much pain, they started crying. Well, the thing was, the person put the spirit's urn by a garbage can. That pissed the spirit off. But the thing about the spirit was that the spirit died in a car crash and his neck was broken. So she started feeling the pain of the spirit whose neck was broken. You have to be careful when you're working with these types of spirits. Now, talking in a manner of this work is that I had this individual that came to me and said, well, you know what? My child's mother is seeing a guy who's having a negative influence over my child. This individual had got an entrancled spirit job done for revenge. This guy was out with an individual. He got into a vicious car crash. The person that was in the passenger side died instantly. Now he's paralyzed. So when you're talking about working with entrancled spirits, you got to know what you're asking for. This is not a game. If you do the ritual wrong, what is supposed to transpire to your victim is going to transpire in your life. So if you have kids, and this is not to deter you, it is just to give you an understanding of what you're getting into. So for you people out here dipping and dabbling, I did an entrancled spirit spell, I burned my little three little, you know, little candles and blah blah blah, and you think that's it. No, it's more to it than that. It's more than that. To light one or four candles and you burn it, and oh, I did the entrancled spirit spell. No, it doesn't work like that. It's more required than just doing foolishness such as that. You have to know your lane. When you try to do things of this nature, you gotta know it's for you. And especially my Haitians out there. You know, those of you claiming to be Wugans and those of you claiming to be Mombos, you gotta know your lane. Because just as they separate the Wugan from the Boko, there has to be a separation between those who walk in the path of Guinea and those who walk in the path of Sopwell. There's a big difference between the two. So for those of you out there seeking to get work done, especially from Haitians, you gotta ask them. You gotta get all the questions clear. Are you at Boko? You know what I'm saying? Do you walk the path of Sopwell? But listen, man, you guys gotta be careful out here. This video is not made to deter you from getting what you want. You just gotta know what you're getting yourself into. You know, because there's too many people out here that inquire about certain things. They're just so emotionally happy and things of that nature. You know, and when things actually hit the fan, now they say they don't want to partake in this anymore. Know what you're dealing with, know who you're dealing with, and know what you're getting done. So with that said, I conclude this video. Thank you guys for watching. Like, share, and subscribe.